Welcome to today's technical video presentation. Tools required for this procedure. Always follow local safety requirements and wear gloves and eye protection. Secure cable and clamping device and measure and mark cable to the desired length. Go to the end of the cable and score the jacket or armor about 4 inches from the end to expose the armor. With a rotary jacket cutting tool or hook blade razor knife, score the jacket at the opposite pencil mark. Flex end of cable at ring cut and with utility knife, slit the jacket longitudinally and remove the jacket to expose the rip cords. With side cutters or splicing scissors, cut a small slit in jacket near the rip cords. Wrap the rip cords with needlenose pliers and pull rip cord to opposite ring cut. Repeat procedure for both rip cords. Cut rip cords leaving several inches in the event that you need to expose additional cable. Remove cable jacket. Cut the strength members, leaving enough length to attach and splice closure per manufacturer's recommendation. Score armor if needed at the end of the cable. Flex and remove the 4 inches of armor. At pencil marked end of cable, score armor as close to the jacket as possible. Using needle nose pliers, wrap the pull strings and pull down the length of the armor. Remove armor and cut off dry water blocking yarns and material. Cut and leave several inches of rip cord for bond clamp installation. Score central tube and flex slightly. Slowly pull off the tube. If the tube is gel filled, remove the bulk of the gel with a clean, dry, lint-free wipe. Follow up with a wipe soaked in 99% isopropyl alcohol. The cable is ready for installation, enclosure, and ready for splicing. Thank you for viewing this technical training video. Please visit our website for additional product information and technical resources.